Hi, I'm Chanel Minifield, and unfortunately Tierra couldn't be with us, but she is doing good in the community right now. So, next interview, she got us. But today we have a hometown hero, and right now he just doesn't have his cape on, but this season he's definitely going to have it on. Today we have Aaron Boyd with us. So, Aaron, you went to Henry Clay High School with my brother. How was that?
It was fun. Good years of my life. Me and Chase, we had some good memories, and you know, I miss him as a good friend. I hope that he's doing well in Virginia right now.
Right. Okay, so what has motivated you all through football, like your whole football career?
You know, just me and my brother setting an example for me at an early age, and my uncle taking me in, you know, asking me early in my life what I wanted to be, and I told him I wanted to be a great athlete, and he's done whatever to get me to that point. So just working me hard and making me grow up as a man.
So when you got sick your freshman year and then you redshirted your sophomore year, was there like ever any doubt in your mind that like football really wasn't for you, like this is just isn't the time?
No, I never really thought that football wasn't for me. God has brought me here so far, and I don't think he's brought me to this point just to stop. You know, it's just been a couple of hard years of my life, and everybody goes through hard times. You know, everything in my life, you know, I've actually worked for, but you know, God told me that you know, I had to humble myself and had to work for things the honest way, and I think that's what he's brought me here to do.
That setback, did that like have you like put in your mind that you like had to work harder, that this just wasn't going to come easy anymore?
Well, yeah, pretty much that set in mind. You know, me getting sick was a bad break. You know, I feel like I've been criticized unfairly for the whole time I've been at the university, but you know, I feel like this year I can come in and have a 100% chance, you know, fair chance of things, and I'm just looking forward to it.
How'd you get criticized? Like, what were people saying?
Basically, just because I was the, you know, one of the top players in the nation, and being a 4-star recruit, I was supposed to come in and contribute early, but, you know, when I got sick, I was overweight, and I wasn't in shape. There was times, there was flashes of my athleticism and what I could do, but there were some days that I didn't feel good, and there were some days that I did feel good, and people really didn't know how much that the whole sickness took from me and how much it affected me.
Dang, that is crucial. So you were playing like when you were like really sick.
Yeah, I was.
Like, actually, what kind of sickness did you have?
I had mononucleosis.
Like, you're not even supposed to like be playing a sport when you have mono.
No.
You're not even supposed to go to school when you have mono. People like take off like 3 months from school with mono.
Yeah.
And you were still playing?
Yeah, like the first 2 days of practice, I was real tired, and I really couldn't like go 2 plays without being tired, and my lymph nodes started to swell up a little bit, and I told the trainers, and they took me to go get tested, and it came back positive. But luckily, we found out the diagnosis before we went into pads the next day, because your spleen swells up, and there's a possible chance of me rupturing it, and I could have died. So that was a big thing. But I missed all of fall camp. That was basically a whole month without football.
Is that basically why you redshirted? Also, is because of your sickness? Did that like play a part with your redshirting?
Yeah, it was the redshirt really was more of a career move, just starting.
So like,
back.
Did people like mentor you on like redshirting? Where they're like, okay, maybe you should take a break off and, you know, like get your strength back and like get stronger in the weight room and all that stuff. Like, did people play a part in that?
Yeah, me and my brother talked about it. Me and Coach Phillips, we talked about it. It's just a chance for me to get caught up. I have good knowledge of the offense, but as far as my strength and everything else to come with it, I wasn't up to speed. And that year off gave me some time to rethink, recollect, and refocus myself, and basically just trying to catch up with everybody else.
With the Boyd name already being established in Lexington because your brother Shane, did you feel like you had like big shoes to fill, like if you didn't make it to the NFL or if you didn't succeed to everybody else's expectation because what Shane set for you, you just like basically like failed at what you were supposed to do?
Yeah, I mean, it's played a big part in my life, you know, early part of my life. Coming into high school, you know, I was criticized and made fun of too, because
people make fun of you?
Yeah.
What?
My brother, I mean, it's because...
Did Shane go to Henry Clay?
Yeah, he went to Henry Clay.
Ooh, that's crucial.
And he was Mr. Everything at Henry Clay. So that was big shoes that I had to fill. And, you know, kind of struggled at first. Well, my freshman year, I played varsity. And, you know, then my sophomore year, I came in, I started as wide receiver. And then, you know, my junior year in high school is when I actually started to separate myself from everybody and started seeing the potential that I could, you know, live up to my brother's name and more. And then my senior year is just when I basically took off and just got my name out there.
Thank you for being on our show, CT Rising Stars, and I wish you the best of luck in your football career and seasons to come, and I hope you do make it to the NFL and that everything goes well. And you heard it from Aaron Boyd. His brother, Mr. Shane Boyd, was Mr. Everything at Henry Clay and also at UK, but here's Aaron Boyd. He's about to make his road gold, and he's about to be Mr. Everything in the world. So look out for Aaron Boyd. His name's going to be out there. He's about to be the next Superman in the world. So thank you for tuning in to our show, CT Rising Stars. CT, over and out.